What's up, everyone? Kawaii Crew here, here to react to episode 10 of Vanitas No Carte. So without further ado, let's get to it. Here we go, episode 10 of Vanitas No Carte. Oh shit, is this Vanitas' past? Who dat? There's no way he's actually that happy to see him. After we know about his attitude towards him. Crying through his goggles, huh? So is this all a ploy to let his guard down? So that's how you're gonna that's how they're gonna make him snitch, huh? Well, he is not enhanced at serving tea, that's for sure. Perhaps I should just let Vanitas do the talking. You know, I feel like being a vampire in like the Vanitas No Carte world universe, I feel like there's really no downside to it because they're not like other vampires. They're not like other vampires where, you know, they, you know, incinerate in sunlight, I'm pretty sure. And, you know, aside from supernatural strengths and superhuman abilities, they act just like any other type of person. They act like humans. I mean, sure, they have red eyes, sure, they may have different color hair, and I mean, sure, they have some all types of magical quirks, like, oh, if you speak bad about their queen, they might go ape shit. But other than that, there's really no downside to it. And plus, you might have a chance at your own sexy vampire spouse. Might go on a date with another hot, sexy vampire, so. And you could suck each other's blood. Dr. Moro is clearly off his rocker. Oh. Oh my. That's what they did to him. That's what you did to him. Eh. There's no way in hell Vanitas forgot about that. I mean, there's no way in hell that Vanitas would be happy that Dr. Moro brought that up again. Huh? Vampire eyes? Oh man, reminds me of that scene in Hunter x Hunter where Kurapika learns that the people who work for the auction in York New City were, you know, they were auctioning off Kurta eyeballs, or like the eyeballs of people that belong to his clan. Ugh. Noe to the rescue. What a bro. And Noe's like, the only number six, no, the only 69 Vanitas cares about is what he's about to do with John. Well, so much for getting information out of him. I guess torture is gonna work. Oh, him. Who? Who? He? Who? Vantos had a brother? What the hell? Oh dear. Oh dear. Predator. That thing straight up looks like some dark sludge monster that you'd fight in Fate Grand Order. It reminds me of those fucking things in Efko Babylonia. Shit, I forgot what they were called. It's been so long since I've played Efko Babylonia or seen the anime. Dame dane, dame yo, dame nani yo. Baka mitai. So what's your plan? Absolute madman! So not only is Noe inside the closet, he also has a four fetish. You are? Man, I haven't heard him refer to himself as a doctor in a long ass time. Damn, it looks like a Tool music video. Uh-oh. Oh, no, no, no. Magic book to the rescue. Ooh. Oh. Very nice. Who's the little boy? Is that Vanitas's brother? I guess Vanitas is back to his old self, I guess you could say. But who is him? Wait, I forgot, who's this? Of course, after the incredibly epic battle, the building has to collapse. Cause of course there is. What mad scientist doesn't have some self-destruct feature inside their own lab or their own facility? Count Orlok? It's actually amazing how friendly and helpful Roland has become. After Noise simply said, "Hey, let's be friends." And it, like, goddamn. Yeah, Vantas, I'm just as shocked. This man was trying to kill them like one or two episodes ago. This man Roland really made a complete 180. Oh? Is this Olivia? Damn! Uh-oh. Man, I feel like this series is just really pushing. This series is really shipping Vanitas and Noe together. I mean, I don't really have a problem with, you know, gay ships, but like, man, I really would prefer if they start, if we get some more, you know, Vanitas and Jean action, you know? Because that's the ship I'm more invested in. Maybe in the last two episodes? I hope Jean is Vanitas' salvation. Alright, well. That was episode 10 of Vanitas no Karate, and it looks like that's the end of that whole ordeal in the catacombs. Well, overall, pretty exciting episode. Get to see Vanitas and Noe, Roland and the Chasseurs fight a big ass shadow monster. Praetor. So yeah, in this episode we found out, I guess we found out a little bit more about Vanitas' past. We know that, you know, he was subjected to some very cruel experiments at the hands of Dr. Moro, and he supposedly has a brother who it seemed like he let him die. Vanitas let his brother die, so because of that he felt guilty throughout his whole life, and because of that he doesn't want anyone else he cares about dying because of him. I guess that's why he was so insistent on Noe. You know, he didn't want Noe to follow him when he was investigating the catacombs and all that. Because Noe being a vampire, he didn't want Noe to be the subject of Dr. Moro's harsh experiments. Oh, wait. Oh, what's this? Damn right. Ruthven? Wait, what? What? So, Charlatan, the Spider Freak, Dr. Moro, and Ruthven, they're all connected? Is that the special subject that Dr. Moro was talking about? Or like the exalted whatever that Moro was talking about? Interesting. That's, wow, because I thought that maybe that exalted somebody that Dr. Moro was talking about, I was thinking that it might have been that woman that we saw at the beginning of the episode, but I guess it's not. Speaking of which, we still don't know who that woman is. I'm guessing she's a Chasseur that saved Vanitas' life or something, but again, that still remains a mystery. I feel like this episode, like, it gave us a little bit more, it answers like some of the questions, but there's still a lot of mystery that we don't know about. In fact, this episode added more mystery. Like, it gave us more questions than it did answers. So yeah, once again, the exact details of Vanitas' past, it remains a huge mystery. And I don't know when we're gonna get the full details. It's probably gonna be in the manga. I don't think it's gonna be in the anime. I highly doubt, like, even if there's like another season of this series, I don't think they're gonna give us all of Vanitas's past. But you know, I can't complain too much. I mean, you know, it's clearly the biggest mystery that this show wants to, you know, present. And, you know, I guess, or like the series wants to present. And I guess we'll get the answers when the time is right. Oh, man, Lord Ruthven as, damn, Lord Ruthven working for Charlatan and the Spider Dude. And it seems like he's working for Dr. Morrow as well. I guess when he assaulted Vanitas a few episodes ago, that wasn't simply because he disrespected the Queen. No, there are other reasons behind it as well, by the looks of it. But yeah, two more episodes left. What the hell are they gonna do in these last two episodes? I guess we're gonna have to wait and see. But yeah, other than that, thank you guys for watching. Have a great day. Subscribe to my channel. Follow me on Twitter. Support me on Patreon. Links in the description down below. And I will see you next time.